Good afternoon, Red Cheerleaders. Pastor Jeremy here. I wanted to take a minute to just check in with you and to give you an encouragement about your leadership with your teams during this current time. You know, I could imagine that for many of our teams, the thought of where we are now, based on where we were a few weeks or even a month ago, is completely different for a lot of us. A month ago, most of our teams were thinking about activities that they were running, roles that they were filling, events that they were planning. And now, as we are looking at April without having any of our normal programmatic church events, and that possibly extending into May, depending on what our state and federal governments decide to do, the temptation maybe, or the error might be to just think, well, there's nothing for my team to do, so my team doesn't need me. And I think that is, it couldn't be more the opposite. I think that right now your team need to hear from you, and they need the voice of your influence, maybe more so now than they've ever needed it before. We know that right now, as people are quarantining and kind of having to practice this isolation for the sake of combating the virus, the discouragement of the isolation and feeling that they're alone and that nobody notices is a significant issue for a lot of people in our church and a lot of people who are on our teams. Now more than ever, your team needs to hear from you, not because you're checking to make sure that a function or a role is being covered, but because their Red Chair leader really wants to know how they're doing. I want to encourage all of our Red Chair leaders over the next 10 days to reach out to every white chair, every one of your team members, and just check in on them. This is going to go a long way to making sure that when this thing is lifted, and it will be lifted, and we will be able to go back to ministering shoulder to shoulder again. But when we do, if we've taken the right steps of caring for our team right now, we will ensure that our team members come back spiritually and emotionally healthy and ready to pick it up and to go back to work and serving God and serving this community. A few months ago, back in January, I wrote a blog with three things that I think a good Red Chair leader can do when connecting with their team. And I think that these three things are probably more important now than ever before. And so I want to share them with you real quick. They are listen up, learn up, and show up. The first one is listen up. As you spend some time making phone calls or having text exchange, it's not just about doing an obligatory check-in phone call. Hey, how's it going? Great. Just wanted to talk to you. Bye. We don't want this to be a surface level kind of conversation. At this point, we are all desperate for more interaction with people. And so we can tell surfaced, forced conversation when we hear it. Instead, I want to invite you to drill in and listen. As they share things about what's going on, as you ask them questions about what's been the hardest thing or the most difficult, or not hardest or difficult, but the most unique thing to adapt to. And as they are sharing those things, really be listening for key insights. It's in their sharing those things that I think you will be able to really get a better idea about where they're at and then know how to speak to those things. Be asking the Holy Spirit to be speaking to you while you're talking to them, and to give you verses or words of truth, or maybe even suggest some books that might help as they are sharing kind of what this journey has been like for them. So really be listening up when you're having those conversations with them. I also want you to learn up, not just be listening to be able to get the information, but really to learn and become a student of your team member. If they are telling you that their daughter is disappointed because her softball season or their son's track season is probably not going to happen this spring, get to know their names, find out where they're going to school, what their events were, what position they played. The next time you talk to them, to be able to ask them questions about their child by name and about those positions or about that role is going to say a lot about how important they are to you. If they're telling you about family members that they're concerned about, maybe ones that don't live in the state or ones that have pre-existing conditions, get to know them by name as well. Be able to ask next time about how it's going with Aunt Sue or with their cousin Bob and his struggle with his health. Ask about their spouse if applicable, in their job and kind of how they're feeling, so that when you come back, you can really speak from a personal level about the things that they are struggling with. This will send a huge message that you care about them as an individual and not just about whether they show up when they're scheduled or when there's an event. So listen up when they're talking, probe deeper, ask bigger conversations, learn up, get to know what is really going on, and be able to speak from a point of personal understanding and reference those things. And the last thing is show up. And this is huge. In this time and what people are dealing with, having the opportunity to set aside what you've got going on and just put yourself in front of the other person. I'll talk about how to do that in just a second. But to be able to be there in their time of need. So not just sending a text or dropping a card, but really letting them see that you were willing to put some things on hold to be able to show up and be in a space where they could see that they matter to you. How do we do that right now while practicing social distancing? We have some of the people on your teams that are really having to quarantine because maybe they've been exposed. Maybe they have to be very careful not to be exposed because they have some other conditions that put them at greater risk. Maybe it's just, you know, an exercise in extreme caution and prudence, and this really hits home for them for one reason or another. You can still go and show yourself to be supporting with them. I heard not too long ago of a mom that took some of her kids to visit some of the different people that attend their church that they're connected with. And they didn't actually go and see them or talk to them, but they took sidewalk chalk and they wrote some messages on their sidewalk so that when they looked, their friends looked outside, they could see that and can wave. I know of a baby shower that happened by dropping things off onto the mom-to-be's porch and then taking a picture with her in inside through the window, just showing. Maiden Lane Church of God recently organized a caravan where they just drove around in front of people's houses honking and waving. What would it look like for you to just take an afternoon to drive to in front of someone's house, get them on the phone and say, hey, look out your window. I'm out here. I just want you to know I'm with you. And if you need anything, please don't hesitate to let me know. You know, it's easy to think that people only care if I show up when I've got something that they're relying on me to do. But it really speaks to knowing that people care when they don't have to and they take time to reach out, when they come back and ask about how a situation is going that I have shared with them, or when they take the time to just show up in some way. Right now, as a Red Chair leader, your influence will go a long way to bringing peace, to bringing calm, and to being able to make sure that your team is being safe and healthy, not just physically, but emotionally and spiritually. So in the next 10 days, would you set as your priority to listen up, learn up, and in some way show up in the lives of your white chairs and the people that are on your red chair team, and just let them know that you care about them, that you're there for them, and they are not walking through this alone. So that's your mission. Set your clocks and get ready to make contact with your team members and let them know that you are paying attention and that you're on they're on your radar. This is what it means to really be a leader. And you guys are doing such a great job of it. I want to encourage you to keep it up and to get creative in this season. Thanks.